Students, whatever homework is given to you, you have to submit it on the very next day between 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. to the given WhatsApp number, and it is compulsory to submit your homework as your attendance will be marked on the basis of your submission.
Last session we have done the cross multiplication method. That means already algebraic methods to find out the solutions. Three methods already you have seen. First one was substitution, second one was elimination, third one was cross multiplication method. So about this cross multiplication method, that I explained in very detail. Then also just to have a glimpse on this cross multiplication method. Here, what you have written here, that coefficients of x, y and constants you have separated, and by this way b1, b2 first, that means the coefficients of y, then constants, then coefficient of x, then coefficient of again the coefficient of y, then cross multiplied, then you have got two relations from here, which are that x upon b1 c2 minus b2 c1, y upon a1 b2 minus c1 a2 minus c2 a1, and 1 upon a1 b2 minus a2 b1. Then between you have got equal to sign also, and equating these two together you are going to get the value of x, and if you are equating these two together you are going to get the value of y. It's already I have explained in the class very nicely last lecture. I have to find out the solution by this cross multiplication method. That also I have seen. You have seen by means of a sum. Here, by this we have already done the solutions of x and y by cross multiplication method. And previous lectures also we have seen that how can you find out that whether the linear equations in two variables have a unique solution, no solution, and infinite solution. What are the conditions for that? What was the condition? First one, that a1 by a2. That means comparing the coefficients, you can say that whether it is having a unique, infinite and no solution. What was that condition? When a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 by b2, then it is a unique solution. And if these three, a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2 are equal, then we have infinite solutions. That means both the equations will represent the same equation only. And third one was that a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2, but constants are not equal. Ratios of constants are not equal. That case, no solution. Now, based on these three steps, we have to now solve our exercise. Next exercise, that is 3.0. Exercise 3.5 is open in your textbook. The question number 1. One was that which of the following pair of linear equations have unique solution, infinite solution, and no solution? If in case there is a unique solution, you have to find out that answer by cross multiplication method. Here already it is mentioned that if there is a solution, then you have to find by cross multiplication. Therefore, you have to opt that method only. No other methods are possible here. Now look at the question. I just to give a idea about that, how to complete that sums. That means, for example, first one, x minus 3y minus 3 equal to 0, 3x minus 9y minus 2 equal to 0. That means here you have to find out the, first of all you have to check that whether the equation is in standard form or not. Standard form means what is that? Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That means constant also you have to take to the left hand side, and then equal to 0 you have to put. That's a very important thing you have to note down here. Then after that, what you will separate the coefficient. That means a1, a2, b1, b2 and c1, c2. After that, next step what is that? You have to find out the ratios. What was the ratios? a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2. These ratios you have to find out. Then next one is that you have to check that a1 by a2 and b1 by b2 are not equal. So you can say that's unique solution. If the three ratios are equal, then you can say that it's having infinite solution. And first two ratios are equal and last ratio is not equal, so you can say that you're having no solution. This one already you have learned in the previous class also. That means exercise 3.3, the same type of sums were there. So there is no need to explain that again. That you can do as the homework. That means exercise 3.5 first question you can do as homework. Four questions are there. That four questions. One thing only you have to read. That means second question you just look at that. 2x plus y equal to 5 is given. So you have to take that 5 also this side and make it as a standard form. That is a very important thing you have to notice here. Other things are as usual. You can do it. Now, like next question number 2. First question. Sub question 1 and question number 2. That question is little bit different from the other sums. And it's also important sum for you. Sometimes it can be asked for the 2 marks questions. So be careful about that. Look at the second question, first one. What is given here that some value of some constant is not given? That means which value of A and B does the following pair of linear equations have infinite number of solution? Here clue already given that this equation is having infinite number of solution. If this equation is having infinite number of solution, you know that A1 by A2 should be equal to B1 by B2 should be equal to C1 by C2. That already given here. But the equation is given like this way. 2x plus 3y equal to 7 was there. In your question, equal to 7. For making it as standard form, you have taken that 7 also this side. That means 2x plus 3y minus 7 equal to 0. Second equation was like this way. A minus B into x plus A plus B into y equal to was there. But I have taken that one also this side. So it will come minus of 3A plus B minus 2 equal to 0. Clear for you? That means both the portions were that side, right hand side. Then you have taken that one also to the left hand side. Now the equation is in the standard form. AX plus BY plus C equal to 0. Now separate the coefficients. That means here A1 will be what will be A1? A1 will be 2, B1 will be 3 and C1 will be minus 7. I have written here. Second one, A1 will be A minus B and A2 will be A minus B, B2 will be A plus B and C2 will be minus of this full constant will be there, full term will be the constant, minus of 3A plus B minus 2. Now here you have written what is the question that which values of A and B this equation will have infinite number of solutions. That is a question. So you have to find out the values of A and B. You have separated the coefficients of each variable and constants. Next step, we know that it will already given that this equation is having what type of solution? Infinite number of solutions. That means the condition will be what? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2. Now, according to this, I have not written that one here, that one step also you have to include here, because it is given here that A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2 already given because it is an infinite solution. Now, compare the ratios, 2 by A minus B, A1 by B2, B1 by B2 is 3 by A plus B and C1 by C2 is minus 7 by 3A plus B minus 2 because of this condition. You are knowing that A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2. Now, first two parts, you will just equate first. 2 by A minus B is equal to 3 by A plus B. Cross multiplication you should do. 2 into A plus B is equal to 3 into A minus B. Then multiply with the 2. 2A plus 2B is equal to 3A minus 3B. Now taking 2A this side and B that side, you are going to get 2A minus 3A is equal to minus 3B and this 2B that side will be minus 5. Minus minus will be cancelled. So you have got one equation like this way, A equal to 5B. But individual values of A and B till now you are not got. Now next step what you should do that you have to again equate the remaining two. This all ratios are equal to each other. Is it right? Therefore, if you are supposed to ratios equal, these two ratios you have equalized first step. Now, next two ratios you take equalize. That means 3 by A plus B is equal to minus 7 by minus of 3A plus B minus 2. That means these two ratios you have equated together. From there, minus minus will be cancelled. Cross multiplied. 3 into 3A plus B minus 2 is equal to 7 into A plus B. This whole terms are under brackets. That's what you should do. That you have to multiply with 3 the whole and 7 also with the whole terms. Now after cross multiplication, you will get like this with the statement 9a plus 3b minus 6 is equal to 7a plus 7b. Now take to A this side and B also I have taken this side. 6 I have taken that side. So 6 will be plus 6. 9a minus 7a, because 7a plus, it will be coming here, it will be minus 7a. Already plus 3b was there, this plus 7b, if it is coming here, it will be minus 7. Now 9a minus 7a, it will come 2a, and 3b minus 7b, that means minus 4b is equal to 6. Now next step it is that, but you know that a equal to 5b already you got from the this equation. So you can put that value of a as 5b. 2 into 5b minus 4b equal to 6. 2 into 5b, 10b. 10b minus 4b equal to 6. 10b minus 4b means 6b. 6b equal to 6. That means b value you got it as 1. 6 upon 6 is 1. Now what will be a value? We have to find out both the values of a and b to satisfy this equation as an infinite number of solution. So you have got b as 1. Now substitute here in this equation. What was that equation? A equal to 5 times b. B value already you have got it as 1. A is equal to 5 into 1 equal to 5. Now you got that answer for this. B equal to 1, A equal to 5 is the answer for this question. That means if you are putting A as 5 and B as 1, you will get that equation have infinitely the infinite number of solution. Let us check that. 2. A minus B means what is that? 5 minus 1, 4. That means 2 by 4. Next one, 3. 3 upon A plus B. A plus B means 5 plus 1. That means 6. So is equal to 3 by 6. Is it right? This one, both are 1 by 2. Now last one, look. C1 by C2. C1 by C2, that means minus 7 upon, if you are doing A as 5 and B as 1. 3 into 5, 15. 15 plus 1, 16. 16 minus 2, how much will come? 14. That means minus 7 by minus 14. This one is also you are going to get equal. That means our equation is having infinite number of solution. When the condition A equal to 5, B is equal to 1, this pair of equation will have infinite number of solutions. Now next is 3.5, question number 2, sub question 2. Here also two linear equations of two variables are given. One pair of linear equation of two variables are given. You have to find out the value of k such way that these equations will have no solution. Previous sum we have done that infinite number of solution. Here the clue is given that this equation is having no solution. No solution condition already you are knowing that a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 should not be equal to c1 by c2. Now let us take, but in our question it is that 3x plus y equal to 1 was there. Therefore I have taken that one also this side to make it as a standard form. That is the first step you have to do. 3x plus y minus 1 equal to 0. Second equation was that 2k minus 1 into x plus k minus 1 into y is equal to was there. So I have taken that one also here. Minus of 2k plus 1 equal to 0. Now next you separated the coefficients. A1 is 3. A2 is 2k minus 1. B1 is 1 because 1 by, but simply by if you return means a, B1 is a 1 and B2 is k minus 1, C1 is minus 1, C2 is minus of 2k plus 1. Now you have separated the coefficients now. Next step what is that? Have to, you already given that this equation is having no solution. So condition you have written that A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 not equal to C1 by C2. Now look at that, a1 by a2, that means I have written this equal to first, that means a1 by equal to a2 equal to b1 by b2, that means 3 by 2k minus 1 is equal to 1 by k minus 1. Now just cross multiply each other and then you got 3 into k minus 1 is equal to 2k minus 1. 3 multiplied with this k minus 1, so 3k minus 3 is equal to 2k minus 1. Now 3k and 2k you have taken here. So 3k minus 2k is equal to minus 1. This minus 3 that side it will be plus 3. You will get 3k minus 2k. How much? How many k's? 1k is equal to 2. Now you are going to substitute this value of k as 2 in this a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2. So whether you are going to get this solution or not, that means a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by, the condition is satisfying or not, that is what you are going to see. Let us know k is equal to 1. If you are substituting in a1 by a2, it will come 3 by 2k minus 1. 3 by 2 into k, k means 2, 2 2's are 4, 4 minus 1, you have got 3 by 3 equal to 1. Second was that b1 by b2, b1 by b2 means 1 upon k minus 1. 1 upon k is 2, 2 minus 1. So 1 upon 1 is equal to 1. That means you have got now a1 upon a2 and b1 upon b2 equal you have got. Because here also 1, here also 1. Now let us check that c1 by c2 is also getting different or not. C1 upon C2, what was that? Minus 1 upon minus of 2k plus 1. Minus minus cancel. Now here 1 upon 2k. K is, which value is substituted for k? K is 2. 1 upon 2 into 2 plus 1 is equal to 1 by 5. Now you have got a1 by a2 and b1 by b2 are equal, but last one c1 by c2 is not equal. That means this equation having no solution. Which case? When k is equal to 2. This case, k is equal to 2, then you will get this equation will have no solution. That means substituting the value of k as 2, you are going to get the answer as no solution. That means a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and not equal to c1 by c2, you are going to get. These two questions are so important for you children. Now x is 3.5. First question already I have given for us the homework, and second question, both the questions I have did it in the class now itself, and third question yesterday I have did it by cross multiplication method. That means previous session I have done by cross multiplication, that was this one only, third question. So 1, 2, 3 was over, and fourth question and fifth question, fourth question there are so many pair of linear equations of two variables you have to make, and you have to do by cross multiplication method. Any algebraic method it is given here, not mentioned that it you have to use cross multiplication. Whichever method you will feel comfortable, that method you can follow. That here also x is 3.5, question number 4 also two questions, 1 and 2 you can do yourself. The remaining through 3 questions I will explain in the next session, because that is so important. Same way this question also, two questions I have told you, that is also so important questions for you. Okay, see you in the next session.